Number 6, verse 22. And the Lord spoke to Moses, not to the board, not to the deacons, not to the trustees. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, this is the way you should bless the children of Israel. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. So they shall put my name on the children of Refresh, and I will bless them. Where I said Refresh, that's Israel. It's talking about us too. Father, we thank you. We bless you for the unusual anointing that rests on a son's life who followed his father faithfully. It is a blessing, God, that's released from a father to a son that begins to permeate his entire being and cause him to walk in levels of understanding and revelation and power that the average person cannot. We thank you now, God, that the endowment of power rests upon me to articulate and declare to your people the blessing of the Lord that maketh rich and add no sorrow with it. Father, take the struggle out of every person's life that's able to believe and receive what I have on my lips today. Father, I thank you that my lips are blessed because you bless my heart. Now my tongue is like a ready writer. I'll write out the future for those who thought their lives were over. We give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise today in the matchless name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Go ahead and take your seats in the presence of the Lord. Faith in the blessing. Faith in the blessing. Faith in the blessing. Faith in the blessing. If we understand anything, if God institutes something, why would we change it? So God instituted through Moses and Aaron and his sons the blessing. This is how you speak to my congregation. This is what you say to my congregation. It's about 3.5 million people. And he said, this is what I want you to say to them. Now, I know many of us come out of environments where every word that's spoken is belittling. But in this house, and we built this house on speaking a blessing, some of them didn't know how to allow the blessing and the correction to couple together. And I'm sorry for correcting scoffers, because the book of Proverbs said, do not correct a scoffer or he will hate you. So if I corrected something that hates me, I apologize. I want to talk to the blessed sons and daughters of Refresh and around the world. So I want to talk to you today because many of us, we work hard to get somewhere and left an open door or given a key to a thief that will come in and take everything that we have. But when the blessing is on you, I don't care how many thieves you're surrounded by, none of them would be able to break in and absorb or take away what the Lord has given you. It is the blessing that God releases on a people to get them through some of the worst times of their lives. It's not that the blessing keeps you away from trauma. Trauma will happen, but you recover quickly when the blessing is on you. When the blessing is on you, you may go through the valley. You may see the shadow of death, but you don't fear any evil, because when the blessing is on you, you know the Lord is with you wherever you may go. When you understand the blessing is on you, you find yourself moving into higher levels of operation that cannot be achieved by those who are afraid because they fear the fact that God won't show up with them. When the blessing is on you, it's a tangible manifestation for those who are going on a journey that family members and old friends and old schoolmates may never go on simply because they don't understand where the blessing will take you. If you feel like you're in a strange place at this certain time, you're only in that strange place because the blessing is on you, because it'll move you into unfamiliar territory. People who do not have a blessing on them, they stay in the same circle. They keep the same friends. They do not go outside of the perimeter. They do not challenge themselves. But when the blessing is on you, it's an automatic challenge that says you're going to get out of that box. And what we're going to do, we're going to make sure you never come back. So we're going to rip the box up so you can never come back and make the box your home. And when the blessing is on you, you can't stabilize and say, this is as far as I'm going to go. When the blessing is on you, you move where the blessing is. Because if the blessing was there, it doesn't mean it'll stay there. The blessing will move. And if you don't find yourself moving with the blessing, you'll find yourself under a curse. So many people talk about the blessing, but your friends are the same. They talk about the blessing, but your residence is the same. You talk about the blessing, but you never moved anywhere. You never moved anywhere because you're afraid, and the blessing doesn't make you afraid. In fact, the blessing makes you like a lion. I walked over into Atlanta, walked up in there like I was a beast. And got major results because the only reason it exists now, I'll tell it, the only reason it exists now because I came through. The pastor that's there now said the only reason it exists is because I came through. That's how people ought to say to you, that's what they should say about you. Once you've been through, something ought to be better than it was before you came through. If it gets worse, that's not a blessing. That's called confusion. So this particular thing that has been spoken over my life, and I want to speak over those who God has given me the jurisdiction over, those who are in the roster of the leadership of the membership of this church or the citizenship of this church, those are the ones I speak over. I dare not speak over anybody else's people, anybody else's church, anybody else's family, because I have no legal rights. I have no way of empowering them if I don't have jurisdiction there. So this particular blessing that came through the administration of heaven, God spoke to Moses. Moses spoke to Aaron and his sons and said, this is the way we're going to bless this people. This is what we're going to say. We're not coming up with a strange prophecy, causing people to be premature and move over into the hands of the devil. We travel in packs. There's a certain thing that's called a blessing, and a blessing is not money, because money without peace is not a blessing. That's why he made it clear. The blessing of the Lord make of rich and add no sorrow with it. If your money added sorrow, it wasn't a blessing. You were just a shrewd person that knew how to get to the other side of things. Now, I'm a businessman. Who all have you cheated just to be successful? Excuse me. So I've been laying the foundation to get us to the place to where now we can start using our faith to believe for the blessing. But if we have no faith, we can't believe for the blessing, nor can we believe for other things that God has for us. Everything, the righteousness of God, comes by faith. You can't be right unless you come to God in faith. That means you cannot have the blessing unless you come to God in faith. You may be smart, but don't get sick. So this particular blessing isn't it's an empowerment. It keeps these people from falling apart when they're going through things that are distasteful. I can always tell you where a blessing is. They still praising in the worst times of their lives. Criticism make them go higher. Talk about me, I'll shift into another dimension. You don't decrease when a blessing is on you. You increase. I can prove it to you in scripture. The more they oppressed them, the more they grew. Why? Because the blessing was on them. It was good that I was afflicted. You start afflicting me, you're going to see the beast of the spirit come out of me. This particular blessing, and it needs to be preached to people like you. Because somewhere in our subconscious mind, we have this argument about whether or not God wants us to succeed. And the Bible says, a double-minded man is unstable in all of his ways. Let not that man believe that he will receive anything from the Lord. A blessed person is not having an alternate conversation in their heads. I'm blessed, it's settled. We're not having another conversation. I don't care if they just came and kicked me out of my house. That means I'm about to get a bigger house. I am blessed. I don't care if they repoed my car. I am blessed. I am going to maintain this attitude until God gives me everything that he said he would give me. My joy is not attached to my stuff. Sometimes the Lord will let something move to see what you are attached to. If the blessing is on you, it's not the stuff. It is on God. God is faithful. Some people are like, well, we're not going to have anything to do with you. So what? I'm blessed. I'll get a new set of friends. Let me say it. Nobody can punk you out when you're blessed like that. Nobody can challenge you. Well, I'm just not going to show up. So what? You're going to miss your blessing because there's a blessing on us. All right. Some of you are the recipients of somebody that was so ignorant they didn't understand nor interpret the blessing that was resting upon this house and resting upon my life, and they walked away from under it and made a space for you. All right. The reason a curse has ruled in the lives of so many people is because we believe in its power. I don't know about you, but I was raised in a household that the curse was talked about more than the blessing. And I'm pretty sure you were raised in that type of household that created fear about everything. Talk negative about everything. Never told me what I could do, just told me what I couldn't do. Boy, you get out there, that thing's going to do this and that thing's going to do that. Why don't you tell me, if you got a blessing on you, what do you see in me? Tell me that I have greatness on the inside of me. I had no one when I was a kid to tell me what I'd be doing right now. That tells me God had to move me because somebody didn't know how to talk to me. Isn't it something, you got greatness in you and nobody knows how to speak to it? You got people all over jealous of you and you don't have parents who know how to speak to the greatness that's on the inside of you. They just trying to get by. They just trying to get over. They just trying to make the ends meet. And all they got to do is speak to the Joseph. And when the Joseph rises up, he's going to feed the whole family. They didn't know you were the one. People can raise you and not know you're the one. You can tell them, I had a dream, and they think you're going crazy. You ain't going crazy. Your rising is for right now, because if you rise right now, they will eat later. So the reason the curse has ruled in the lives of so many people is because we believe in it, in its power. So they start saying something negative about you, and you get all upset. You want to know why you get upset? Because you believe it. You say whatever you want to say. Don't bother me. It's an announcement that it's my time. When Judas betrays me, it's an announcement that it's my time. When a Peter walks away from me, it's an announcement that it's my time. Read your Bible. I cannot get to my next level of glory unless I got a betrayal and somebody that said they will be faithful to me to break covenant and walk away from me. So let me help some of y'all who had some bad things to happen in a good season. It was the announcement that it is the season. You're always looking for family members and friends to announce it. They've been jealous of you all your life. Why would they tell you it's your time? The blessing will always make people jealous, and you don't even know what they're jealous about because you don't know what you're wearing. They're always trying to talk you out of what God is trying to talk you into. I came to talk you into what God wants you talked into. Anytime they run up to you and say, "You, why are you all over that man?" It's because they cursed. You chasing a blessing. Jacob was chasing a blessing. Whenever they consider it trivial. And they know I need something on me. When they undervalue the blessing, they wind up being a subservient person for the rest of their lives. I'll chase it because I'm not staying here. I'll chase it. Where you going to be at, man of God? I'm going to be right there. Because I'm going to chase it because I'm going to get this. I know where I came from. I'm very familiar where I came from. And I'm so far out of it, I never want to go back to it. So I'm going to chase my way out because I'm never going back to where I came from. It's a curse after me, but it will never get me again. I'll never know what it is to be in poverty again. I'll never know what it is to struggle to pay bills again. Somebody needs to chase that right there. If you get nervous at the first of the month, get what's on me on you. And I promise you, you don't have to be nervous at the beginning of the month, the middle of the month, the end of the month. It don't matter. When the blessing is on you, God is obligated to bring a ram and put it in place. Even if you don't see it, He is Jehovah Jireh. He is the provider. You want me to run my blood pressure up, want me to engage in the confusion that you're engaged in. And if I wasn't on a platform and everybody wouldn't hear me, I would say it a little bit different way. But heavens no. You've been around here long enough, you know how I would word that. But I'm going to say heavens no. There's a certain boldness in your character that you carry when you got a blessing on you. There's a certain persona that you have when you got a blessing on you. Yeah, you just demoted me so I can take your position over you. That's a certain persona. You don't get all upset. You don't get upset when they don't come and tell about you and you just done a miracle for them. You just helped them. Can you imagine how many years I've been helping people and no one says anything about it? I'm not upset. I'm just going to another dimension to help another group of people. Let me help some of y'all. The ones that you're helping don't understand that they should appreciate you. Go to the next level. The reason they don't appreciate you because you're on the wrong level. The reason they ain't celebrating you is because you're on the wrong level. Get out of that room. Go to the next room. If they throw a party when you're in, get in that room, you're in the right room. You can always tell when you're in the right room. There's a pleasant greeting and nobody's trying to nail you to the cross. It's because they see the blessing on you. You've been in rooms where people have been blind and jealous and got all these things going on. But when you get in a different room, look at your neighbor, don't touch him, but say you're in a different room now. When the blessing is on you, I hope you're good at what you do because I'm very good at what I do because the blessing is on me in my area. Why should I be jealous of anybody? I'm good at what I do because the blessing is on me. Well, I think that's arrogant. I feel like it's the blessing according to the word, and I know you're just jealous because you don't know what you're supposed to be doing. Let me help you. Let me pause right here. Some of you look for a place to be used instead of a place that has a blessing on it. That's why you're going to get used up. You always search for a place that has a blessing on it because if it has a blessing on it, you're guaranteed to rise. I don't know who that's for, but that was free. In the same way, if we believe in the blessing, it will rule in our lives. If we believe in the blessing like we believe in a curse, like we believe in the negativity from the homes and the communities that we came out of, if we believe in the blessing to that degree, then the blessing will outrule any type of curses, any kind of words that were spoken, any kind of environments that we were brought into. But you got to believe in the blessing. You got to believe if that word is spoken over you, it's going to override any other negative words that were spoken to you. You got to believe that this particular blessing is going to break you out of whatever you've been in. And this blessing came after 400 years of slavery. God knew that they were going to need something said over them because they had suffered for over 400 years. And when you've suffered like that, you need somebody to say something to you that nobody in your household. How's a slave going to tell another slave you're blessed? In the same way, if we believe in the blessing, not a car, not a house, that stuff is the result of the blessing. That is not the blessing. In the same way, if we believe in the blessing, it will rule in our lives. Listen, this is a positive message, and you got a negative situation, which this is what you need to hear to combat what you're dealing with. Now, some of y'all over the weekend said, Lord, I just need to hear something. Now you said, Lord, I need to hear something, but you want to hear it from your own inner prophet. Now that you ask God to say something, do you have ears to hear what the Spirit is saying to the church? Or have you gone deaf between home and the church? Because it's what they heard that changed the way they thought, that shifted them into where God wanted to take them. They were out of slavery, but then still thought like a slave. You ever been out of something and then thought like you were still in it? You'd be surprised at how many people are not sick but think like they're sick. When you align yourself with the blessing, the results will be what? Staggering over a period of time. If you have time, get ready for a staggering blessing. Let me help y'all just because I just turned 57. Most of my years of being 26, I was in a hurry. And I would say it to myself, I'm getting older now. In a lot of my meetings, I said, and so I had to check myself. What's age got to do with it? If I'm blessed, God can do all of it in one day. See, we can tell when you don't have the blessing, you get in a hurry and you start doing things that you should not do. And you wonder why old people are so hasty because they feel like they're running out of time. When the blessing is on you, you redeem time. Where you lost a day, you gain two more. Where you lost a week, you gain a month. I have a strength of 1,000 men on me as I get older. Why? Because the blessing of the Lord is on me. It would be staggering. I always remember, I'm watching this movie, the movie called Ghost. Patrick Swayze in it and what's her name? Whoopi Goldberg in it. And when he tells her she's got to give this check up. $3 million. She thought she was going to go do some bling bling. And he said, no, you got to give up this check or they're going to come looking for you. And they're in this struggle. And then she puts it in the hands of the nun. And the nun, he's telling her, let it go, let it go. The nun pulling on it, she's pulling on it. And suddenly she lets go of it. And the other nun next to her, they look at one another. She opens up the check and she falls. She stumbles because it was a staggering blessing. I believe when you open up this next phase of your life, I hope you got somebody you trust standing next to you, because this next thing that God's going to do in your life is going to make you stagger. And I believe that you need to make sure you change some friends. You need to plan for where the blessing is taking you. And if the blessing is taking you to a great place, you better make sure you got somebody to hold you up, because when you get to this one, you're going to start staggering. We're going to silence all the critics. They ain't got a clue what's going on. They trying to get a pension. They trying to get retirement. No, we're trying to get our inheritance. It is much more than a pension. It is much more than retirement. I'll do more when I retire than I did while I was working. I'll step over into the next phase of operation. I'll step over into the next level of glory. You got to know over a period of time when it's time. I've been telling y'all we're in a Kairos moment. Y'all keep going home and forgetting what I told you. Then you come back in here and you're looking weird on me. And I'm like, didn't you hear what I said? Who you talking to between here and back home? What if you having conversations that create doubt in you? I believe you need to loosen up that relationship. The blessing will shift. Listen to them. The blessing will shift a mind that has experienced overwhelming suffering to a mind ready to receive untold blessings. If people have great destiny on the inside of them, you have to preach the blessing upon them. And then their minds will shift from the trauma. If minds stay in the trauma, they're resisting the word of God, because there's no way you can preach the unadulterated word of God, the blessing upon them, and they don't rise up out of the ashes. It's their resisting, because the word of God is sharper than a double-edged sword to the dividing of the sunder of both joint and marrow, soul and spirit. It'll work on your spirit, but it'll work on your soul, or the devil's trying to bind you. Get your mind out of it and receive the blessing. He's teaching those people all that stuff, trying to get the people to believe that stuff. Everything starts with believing. Will you please dismiss your unsaved self from our arena so that we can get a hold of God? Because if you don't believe, you're not saved, and you're in the wrong company right now, because we are blessed people and nobody can do anything to stop it. So it'll shift a mind. The blessing will shift a mind that has experience. It's not that you don't have a bad experience. It's not that you have not gone through. It's not that bad things have not happened to you. But bad things can happen, but you don't have to think like what happened to you. A lot of stuff happened to me over the years. I've been a man of integrity since day one, and crooks always tried to run with me. But it's okay. I'm going to stay in integrity. I'm going to keep doing what God called me to do. And I will not become what they said. I am who I am. Come on, say that. I am who I am. I started to think as I was driving back from Atlanta this morning. I started to think, so many people, if they were sick, I would just go sit with them. Some people got better. I never had to pray for them. I just sat and had a conversation with them. And all of a sudden, they started feeling better. I said, well, I don't have to pray now. I can leave. That happened so many times because what I'd done, I exposed them and they were receptive to the blessing that was on my life. Sickness can't stay where the blessing is. That's why you got to be careful. If you start categorizing, God sent individuals with those who went, you're going to miss your blessing. The overwhelming suffering. I know I'm called to people who have gone through overwhelming suffering, unjust things. Just don't make sense. You ever had something happen to you? It just didn't make any sense. Most of you are in under the sound of my voice right now. Just things that just really didn't make any sense. Let me tell you what was happening. God was repositioning you so he can get you to where he wanted you to be. It was only when Joseph had been sold out by his brothers, told his father that he was dead, stripped of his garment, that he arrived in the place that he would rule. Some of you would never walk there. God has to send you there, possibly in handcuffs. You go in as a prisoner and come out the ruler. When the blessing is on you, see, y'all don't understand. You go in as a prisoner and you come out a ruler. That's what the blessing does. I just need to get you geographically where I need you to be so that you can go up. Some of y'all never come up because you're so attached to your brothers and your sisters that you won't get. Let me tell you what made me go. How they treated me. They treated me bad, so it made me shift to where I was supposed to go. They didn't celebrate me, and I like celebration, so I went to where the celebration was. They didn't respect me, so I went to a respectful room. I understand that hogs and pigs, they don't understand the valuable pearls, so I went to a place where there wasn't no hogs and pigs. And the authenticity of the blessing that was on Jacob never manifested until he got around his trickster uncle. How do you know the blessing is on you? It's when you get in crisis and you thrive. Well, I'm so down. No, well, you ain't down and out. You're up and in. Get yourself together. Pull your pants up. How dare you not be ready after being in the dungeon, Joseph? You should have been practicing your anointing while you were in the dungeon. Now, your gift don't start working when you get to the palace. Your gift was working when you were in the dungeon, when it was dark, when nobody respected you and nobody remembered you. That's when your gifting, my gifting was working when I was down low. So when I come up higher, the blessing in the dungeon is a blessing while I rule. The blessing on you causes you to survive. That's what the blessing does. It causes you to survive until you thrive. But you got to survive if you're going to thrive. But the blessing keeps you. When everybody else is giving up. When everybody's throwing the towel in. When everybody else is quitting. Because you know God's got thriving on his mind. Because the blessing is on you. Looking down on you because you're going through a little something. They don't know that it's a sign that you're about to get an upgrade. Some people stay in the same place all their lives. Some people are trying to tell me stuff. I'm like, you're still in the third grade. I went through hell in the first grade and you were laughing at me. Now I'm in college and you want to tell me what to do. They survived. The blessing was on them. They survived. Not that it's not difficult. Not that it's not hard. They survived because the blessing was on them. People trying to determine whether the blessing is on you by looking at what kind of car you're driving. They are so elementary. I was on the phone with a friend the other day, and he's in Atlanta. He's the largest landowner in Atlanta. And we were on the phone just the other day, and he calls me Bishop Davis. And this is how I do it. In business, I use bishop. In church, I use apostle. So when I'm doing business, I use bishop, because they don't understand apostle. So I use my title bishop. That's why I'm Apostle Bishop Stephen A. Davis. So I interchange those titles. Not that I degrade myself. I just say they don't understand. I still want this business to go in my favor. So I'm going to use bishop with them. Some of y'all need to wise up. You're pushing your titles too far. He said to me, Bishop Davis, he said, there are all kind of conversations that are going on about you. He said, there are people who are having conversations about you that you may not have any idea of those conversations. He said, I was just in one of those conversations just the other day. And see, you got to understand, when the blessing is on you, when you feel like people are always talking about you, if you put all your attention on the naysayers who are talking about you, you'll miss out on the conversations that are talking for you. The favorable conversations. There's some favorable conversations. Somebody say this with me. There's some favorable conversations that are going on about me. All the negative conversations are a sign that somebody's talking positive about you too. You choose which one you want to hear. My wife will tell you, we've had some positive conversations about some people, really positive, just things we want to do to be a blessing. And then they come in and they act like the negative conversations that people have had or said about them or spoke about them. You have to be careful when the negativity lingers in your head more than the blessing does. Everybody's not messy. And all church people are not messy. You ought to know that by now. You work in an office and with a lot of negative people, messy people. Mess is everywhere, but there's some goodness too. If I think, and I preach the whole Bible today, but if I think about Elijah, he said, I'm the only one left. No, God said, I reserved myself 7,000 who have not bowed their knee to Baal. There's always some good people. I don't care how many bad people you've been around, how many negative people. So get that out of your head, or you're going to miss your destiny. It's overwhelming suffering to a mind ready to receive untold blessing. What God wants to do for you doesn't make any sense. Not going to make any sense to your family. It's not going to make any sense to your friends. They can't figure out why you come to worship. And if they can't figure out why you come to worship, they're surely not going to figure out why you're blessed. It's what's said to you. It's what's said to you. What's said to you hindered you. What's said to you can propel you. Let me help y'all. The devil uses God's tactics in reverse. So instead of applauding you, they wag their heads at you, because that's how Satan works, to discourage you. Well, on the other side, there's another group of people who will celebrate you. Tell you, go for it. Give it all you got. Don't stop. If I was a rapper, I'd say, don't stop. Get it. Somebody need to get a revelation for 2024, because this man in this house, we are not going to stop. We're going to get it. You waiting on me to stop? You got a cursed mind, because people like me don't stop. We transition, but we drop a mantle while we're transitioning, so we don't stop. That's why they talk about y'all calling y'all hood, because y'all always into that. Listen to this. This blessing will grant us fruitful harvests, not a harvest. Fruitful harvests. This is the thing. I look at my grass I got some nice grass in my yard, but it's brown right now because of the seasons. I know it's coming back. Some of y'all don't understand harvest time. That's why you're so negative. You don't understand seasons. But God promised that it will be seed time, harvest time, cold and hot, winter and summer. That's what he said. So my grass that's brown right now doesn't look real good. It's nice and neat, but it doesn't look real good. But if I just wait just a little while, if I wait just a little while, what was brown is going to turn back green. What has no blooms on it will start to bloom again. That's why I have to prune it, because it's going to bear much fruit. Fruitful harvest is increase of cattle. When you increase cattle, that represents wealth in those days. If you had cattle, you had wealth. So increase of cattle, it represents increase of wealth and success in all undertakings. Any responsibility that you touch that comes from God is going to flourish. Let me prove it to you. I lead refresh. It ain't shutting down. Lady Davis leads my wall of women. That's my legal organization. Let me do this. Just put some in the atmosphere, wild women. So it's working. I legally have meet me at the 50. Everything under my hands, and you can ask Lady Davis how the household and Sasha how the households go. Everything under my hands right now is not dying, it's alive. That's called the blessing. I'm saying to you, your business with the blessing on you. Don't back off. Your business, whatever you're doing, if the blessing is on you, get ready to flourish. You need to get ready to handle your clientele. You ain't got time to be using your mind to worry. You got to come up with a strategy, because increase demands that you have a strategy. So you need to be working on your strategic plan for the increase that God is bringing in your life, because if the devil can't stop it, the only thing that can stop it is you not having good stewardship for what God is sending. Oh boy, you preaching up in here today. The blessing may take you through a winter season, but it's a guarantee that summer is coming. I said it's a guarantee that summer is coming. It's a guarantee that summer is coming. Do you have enough faith to believe that summertime is coming, or are you going to throw the towel in and give up? I'm so glad my father used to say, watch this. What he was saying is, watch the seasons turn. If I could sing, I said, it's my season. I know your haters don't want you to believe like that, but it's my season. You got to know when your season comes around. You got to know it because you need to change your tools when your season. You need harvesting tools, not plowing tools. Okay. Let me say this before I get to my next point. Sasha, they have a challenge with the way I do things. But the fire department tomorrow night will install me as the chaplain. And to be honest, they don't have a problem with me. They jealous of me. They call me Monday Tim. They said, can you be here on Monday night at 5:30? We're going to swear you in. Did I ask for it? No. Did I apply for it? No. Am I blessed for it? Yes. And I'm not going to tell you what I thought I started thinking. Because God's got to show some of y'all something. You can't confine me to this pulpit. I came to take over. Let me get to my last two points. Look at him. Look at your neighbor. Tell him God's going to make a believer out of you. Can I do something before I go into my next two points? Because they have a tendency, when an African-American man is up preaching, they have a tendency to say that we're just after money and we're just all about blessing. Well, this is Deuteronomy chapter 28. It says, listen to this. It shall come to pass, if you hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord your God and observe carefully all his commandments, which I command you today, that the Lord your God will set you on high above all the nations of the earth. And all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. Now, the scripture is saying that. Why should I not believe it? I'm going to preach that one day, so you might as well get ready, because everything I preach, God's backing it up. And won't you give a shout in the atmosphere, because we got heaven support. Listen to this. The face of the Lord shines on us. Are shining on us is a sign of inner pleasure and a favorable disposition to him. So God's face, the scripture says that his face, the Lord, make your face shine upon me. So his face shining on us is a sign to us that he has inner pleasure for us. God is so into you. God is so into you. God is so into you. He's so into you. He's turned towards a favorable posture towards you. Isn't it something that you don't know you're favored and he's favoring you? I can always determine how much favor is on my life by the room that he allows me to enter. He would never put you in certain rooms if he wasn't favoring you. Because in certain rooms, there are certain conversations that you will hear. When you're not favored, you're on the outskirts of conversation. When you're favored, you're right there at the table. Thank God for a seat at the table. Let's go on, because his face is shining on us. Now let's talk about his countenance, because verse 26 talks about his countenance. Lord, lift up your countenance upon me and give me peace. But this is point says this. Us can be at peace because the Lord's countenance is towards us. Come here, community bishop. You're right here. I'm God. It doesn't matter what you're dealing with. As long as I'm turned towards you, it's going to work out for your good. As long as my countenance, I hadn't moved yet, but I'm turned towards you. I hadn't healed you yet, but I'm turned towards you. I hadn't sent the money yet, but I'm turned towards you. I hadn't backed off the enemy yet, but I'm turned towards you. And as long as I'm turned towards you, my countenance is towards you. You don't wait until the battle is over. You start shouting right now. Come here, community bishop. Come here, you ran away too quick. This represents you in trouble. You're in major trouble when God turns his back. Jesus said, "Why hast thou forsaken me?" Which means that God turned his back while Jesus was on the cross. I want to tell y'all, as I prepare to close, and you prepare to go over and enjoy gifts and shop with the vendors. In this season, God has turned around. And if you've been waiting to get God's attention, you have it right now. What are you going to do with the moment that you have? A moment of blessing, a moment of victory, a moment of increase. It's yours. It's yours. Can't take it from me. It's yours. It's yours. His face is turned towards you.
It's yours. It's yours.
Moment, we're not stopping. Where's Shawty at? Shawty is the one they think is disqualified, and God just qualified them through the blessing. Where my Shawty's at? I'm not talking about in stature. I'm talking about where my Shawty's at that thought it was all over. Go, go. Get it, get it. Because it's yours. So every disqualified Shawty, the blessing just came on your life right now. It's yours.
It's yours. It's yours.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's yours. Yeah. Hey, it's yours.
It's yours.
It's yours. Yeah, it's yours.
It's yours.
Don't stop, get it, get it, don't stop, get it, get it, get it.
Genesis, you know, and I've been thinking for weeks now, and I even told the staff, I said, you can't control people nowadays. And equality, intelligent leadership gets ahead of the people and uses influence. Influence is leadership. And those people under your influence begin to move into that which God has shown. So my approach is not to manage. For 5 or 6 years, I've been there. If you get behind me and you follow what I'm teaching, you're about to live the most unusual life that you ever could have lived, because what's on me is generational. There ain't many that could have submitted like I submitted, so I got what they couldn't get. But it's flowing now. The climate here was unusual for this city. But I went there and saw 23,000 people who were just like what you are right here. Religion tried to close our city in. But if you can show me, because see, healing with traumatized people, there has to be some action. You can sit there as long as you want to with your legs crossed, but I know slavery is still trying to come back and get you. So when you start expressing yourself, it's therapy. It's therapy. From the trauma. That's why our services are like they are, because so many in this place and streaming have been traumatized, but their freedom has come because we dare to be different. Closing after this, if you want to be a part of this ministry, you're going to have the opportunity. Kayla, they see me like this, but I see me sitting at an executive table that's so long, and I'm declaring my vision, and I got people all around that table with laptops trying to figure out how to get my vision done because it's so large. 24 people sitting at that table. Some of them will leave major companies to come work for me. They can't see that though. They think this is foolishness. God says, I chose the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. I'm going to have 24 people sitting there, and I'll be at the head of the table. And I said, this is where we're going. Make it happen. You need to change your whole perspective. When the blessing is on you, don't try to do all the work. Have the ideas, the vision, and know where you're going, and make sure you got qualified people sitting at that table that can make it happen. Tell them, we're about to make it happen.